السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 2121. And today, with the grace and mercy of Allah Azza wa Jalla, we focus on 16th of Safar. An Abi Hurairah radiallahu an, it is reported on the authority of Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu an, the hadith in Ibn Majah, إنه لقيه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حبيبنا صلى الله عليه وسلم met him, meaning نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم saw سيدنا أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه في طريق من طرق المدينة, in one of the gullies, alleys of مدينة منورة, وهو جنوب, whilst he was in the state of جنوب, where he needed a compulsory bath, maybe wet dream, or maybe remember that he was not married also that time, so must be wet dream. Fansalla, so he went away discreetly, that is Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. Then he went to take a ghusl and a compulsory bath. Fafaqadahu an-nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was rendering the advices, he found that Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu was missing initially. Falamma ja'a, and then when he, Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, came, call, Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, Aina kunta ya Abu Huraira? Where you went, where you were, O Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, call. He said, Ya Rasulullah, O Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, laqitani. You saw me from a distance, wa ana junub, whilst I was in ceremonial impurity. I needed a compulsory ghusl and a bath, wa ana junubun. فَكَرِهْتُ أَنْ أُجَالِسَكَ, so I dislike to sit next to you in your majlis, Mubarak majlis, حَتَّى أَغْتَسِلْ, till I take a bath. Quran Kareem states, وَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ جُنُوبًا فَتْطَهَرُوا, when you are in the state of junub, then you must take a bath, and compulsory it is. You can't be delaying and missing salat in the process, compulsory salat. فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, حَبِيبُنَا مُصْطَفَى صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ said, الْمُؤْمِنُ لَا يَنْجُسْ. When an incident takes place and a Quranic verse gets revealed, we call that sababun nuzul, the reason why the ayat, the verses were revealed. An incident takes place and remember Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam utters the Mubarak blessed words, like in this case here, individually we call it sababul wurud, the reason for the announcement of the Master Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the plural asbabul wurud. Allama Suyuti rahimahullah was a prolific writer. He wrote books on all this. I have them myself, alhamdulillah. Asbabul Wurud, Asbabun Nuzul, and so forth. So we should refer to that, an interesting incident you will find. Now when Sayyidina Abu Huraira said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I went to take my ghusl and I dislike to sit in your Mubarak majlis. On that occasion, Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-mu'minu la yanjus. A mu'min is not napak. What it means? It means that if you came to meet me or made salam to me or you touch me or I touch you, it don't mean if you are napak and you touch me, you shook hand with me, then I become napak. No. I touch you and you are napak, so it didn't mean I become napak. So understand, ghusl is still compulsory. So look at the beauty of Islam here. People today are traveling by plane, by train, by bus, so non-Muslims are there, or a Muslim is there, and now that person touches you, so they don't going to worry about hatahi, taharat and najasat. So you can't say because he touched you, so you napak now, that there must be some najasat, some impurity which is visible, and if that touch you, then you will say it is napaki and impurity and so forth. So similarly with the lady, she is in a haze or menses, she meets another lady, you can't say because she shook hand with that lady or embraced that lady, so now the other lady became napak. So look at the beauty and the beauty of mahasina Islam, that these are the laws of Islam which are so practical, and we need to show this to humanity. May Almighty Allah grant us the true understanding of deen. Ameen. Ya Rabbal Alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.